Good morning, students. Today we are going to start with the very first chapter in our first term English literature, that is Tenali meets Babar. I hope that most of you, or I can say all of you, have heard about the particular name Tenali Raman. You may have heard it in cartoon films or in any TV serials. So I think that you know who is this Tenali Raman. But still I'm explaining that Tenali Raman was a famous jester and a poet in the court of Krishnadev Raya, the king of Vijayanagar. So Tenali Raman was a famous jester. Jester means one who makes jokes or teases, or you can say a joker, who make laugh to everybody. So Tenali Raman was a jester. Along with the jester, he was a poet also in the court of Krishnadev Rai, the king of Vijayanagar. I will mention some of the other persons who are having the same jester qualities and who used to stay in the courts of other kings too. For example, you have heard the name of Gopal Bhar. Gopal Bhar, who was in the court of Raja Krishna Chandra, the famous king of Nodia in the 18th century in Bengal. Nodia means which is a district in West Bengal now. Along with Gopal Bhar, another character is also there, and his name is Birbal. Akbar ke Birbal. I hope you heard this term, Akbar ke Birbal. So Birbal, he was one of the Navratnas. Navratnas means nine jewels of Akbar, in the court of Akbar. So this Tenali Raman, Gopal Bhar, Birbal, all are having the same types of qualities in them. What are these qualities? They are jesters, they are intelligent, and they used to make laugh or give intelligent thoughts to their king. So many stories are told of his wit and wisdom. So Tenali Raman was so intelligent that his stories related to his wit and wisdom are spreaded everywhere in the country. So here in this story we will read about one of his adventurous trip to the court of Babar. So don't get confused that Tenali Raman was a jester in the court of Babar. Tenali Raman was a jester in the court of Krishnadev Raya, who was the king of Vijayanagar. And he once visited Babar's court and had a adventure there. So what was that adventure? We will explain now. Once again, let you know that Vijayanagar, where is this Vijayanagar located? Vijayanagar is a place which is located in the present day Bengaluru, Karnataka, and I hope you know Bengaluru, Karnataka well. So Vijayanagar is the name of that particular place. Now come to the story. The tales related to Tenali Raman's intelligence and wit had reached far and wide. Tenali Raman's intelligent stories, his witty activities have reached all the corners of the country. So, they also reached the Mughal court in Delhi, where Emperor Babur ruled. So, his stories of intelligence was not only limited within the kingdom of Vijayanagar, rather it spread throughout the country, means throughout India, and his story also reached to the ears of Delhi Emperor, who was there, Babur, who was the first ruler of Mughal dynasty. So hearing about Tenali Raman, Babur wished to meet him and sent a messenger. So as he was very intelligent, everywhere the rumors of Tenali Raman's intelligence spreading like a jungle fire. So he was so pleased to meet him personally in his darbar or in his court. When Babur's messenger reached Vijayanagar, Raja Krishnadev Raya, the ruler, grew apprehensive. So Babur sent one of his messenger to Raja Krishnadev Raya's court. So when he reached, means the messenger reached to Raja Krishnadev Raya's court, the ruler, means the king, Krishnadev Raya, grew apprehensive. Grew apprehensive means grew or became anxious. Became anxious means he was quite tensed or worried. Why the Babur sent a messenger to his court? It's very obvious that Mughal emperor sent a messenger to his court. It must be a matter of question. He thought that the Mughal emperor had sent his messenger to find an excuse to attack his kingdom, but he was thinking it in some other way. He was thinking, means Raja Krishnadev Raya was thinking, that Babur sent the messenger just as an excuse to attack his kingdom. It was an excuse. He was trying to inform Raja Krishnadev Raya that the king or the ruler of Mughal dynasty is going to attack on Vijayanagar. The Raja was relieved when the messenger said, but whatever queries or whatever critical thoughts that coming in Raja Krishnadev Raya's mind completely get dissolved when he heard the messenger said that our emperor wants to meet Tenali Raman Maharaj. Please send him with me to the Delhi court. What he said, whatever was his expectation, the thought was completely different. The messenger said that our emperor, means Babur, simply wants to meet Tenali Raman. So he is asking Maharaj, means Krishnadev Raya, please send Mr. Tenali Raman with him to the Delhi court. See, in simple way, the Raja agreed. So it's very obvious that Raja will agree to this proposal. He said, Tenali, I order you to go with this messenger to the Mughal court and prove your mettle. And he called Tenali Raman and told him that, Tenali, you are ordered to go with the messenger to the Mughal court and prove your mettle. Prove your mettle means prove your worth or prove your power or prove your talent or whatever features you are having within you about your weight and wisdom. You have to prove all of them in front of Babur. Remember, the honor of our kingdom is in your hands. And what you have to remember, the honor of our kingdom means Vijayanagar kingdom, is in the hands of you only. If you prove yourself successful enough in front of Babur, along with you, I will be also rewarded. I will be honored in front of others. If you impress the emperor and get a reward from him, I promise to gift you 10,000 gold coins. And he also promised Tenali Raman that if you will be successful to get a reward from Babur after proving yourself in front of him, then I am also promising you that whenever you will return back to the kingdom, to Vijayanagar, I will also gift you with the 10,000 gold coins. This much is clear? Yes, of course. I hope so. If any query you are having, you let me know after the finishing of the video. Now, Tenali replied, I will not let you down, Your Majesty. Tenali, of course, he will say that no need to worry, my lord. I will prove and I will try my level best to make my name and your fame both high in front of Babur. So the next day, Tenali left with messenger. So what happened next day? The messenger from Babur, from Babur's side, and Tenali both started their journey towards Delhi. When Babur heard that Tenali Raman had arrived, so when Babur heard that Tenali and his messengers, they already arrived at their court, he said to his courtiers, he told something to his courtiers. What was that? You all know he is a very witty man. Babur told to his courtiers that you people are very aware of the witty behavior of Tenali Raman. As we all know that Tenali Raman is a very intelligent person. So however, if I find anyone laughing at his jokes, that person shall be punished. He ordered that no one present in the court will laugh at the jokes of Tenali. That is an order. And if anybody was found laughing at the jokes of Tenali Raman, that particular person will be punished, severely punished. At the royal court, Tenali tried many antics. Many antics means many unusual behaviors, many funny activities. Tenali Raman is now present at the court and he is trying his level best to make Raja and the courtiers laugh at his jokes. But no one smiled. Why they are not smiling? Because it is a strict order from the Raja Babar's side, no one will laugh. So nobody was smiling. Everybody was at a static stick position. He said many amusing, witty and wise things, but to no effect. He was trying many witty, many wise, intelligent activities, thoughts, jokes, but everything was in vain. Nothing was applied on them. He was not successful in applying any of his techniques or tricks. 15 days passed by, but all his efforts to make people laugh failed. So every effort, every techniques was in vain. Tenali understood that something was amiss. And finally, Tenali understood that whatever things he is doing, he is unsuccessful in making them laugh. So he understood that something was amiss, something was wrong. Something was already created. It's a created thing. So he understood something is wrong. He realized that the Mughal courtiers were deliberately keeping a somber face. And he also found that all the Mughal courtiers, means all the Darbaris in the Darbar, they are always trying to keep a serious face. Means they are trying to make it. They are trying their level best to make a serious face over there. So Tenali knew that defeat would mean losing prestige and honor for Vijayanagar. So Tenali, as he knew that if I will not be successful, it simply means losing prestige of myself along with my king as well as my kingdom Vijayanagar, as well as his own position there. So he thought of a plan. What he thought? He made an intelligent plan. As he is an intelligent person, so he made an intelligent plan through which he would try to make all the courtiers along with the King Babar laugh or react on him or on his jokes. So this much for the day, children. We will start our next paragraph in the next video. I hope you are understanding the way I'm explaining. But if you are having any problem, any query related to these through three paragraphs, you please ask me whenever you feel so. Thank you so much. Study at home.